I think so, yeah.
Let's still get the decent.
And that's wrong.
Andre, I'm going.
Right. He's a giant.
He's a big fat sausage. That is mine. That's
he's got a fat sausage.
Oh,
me, Jean, what have you
sir, you look
done to me? Me. Well, I guess it doesn't matter anymore.
Chief of the server.
Then you go your own.
Where's the big nanny monster?
Where's the cookie monster?
Yeah. There's that's the big right. Nanny
you
monster
tell her
there.
Nanny monster.
I'm gonna go get a hat.
world. Come on, here, take it here. Get in between you and stand by the side of your nanny.
Won't you kiss me on the
And can one of the lads be a gentleman and actually go and get it for me?
Look at that, no one's going to
pick it. Oh, the green door.
I have to say, you really made me proud today. I thought you were beautiful. So that's all I can say, because you were really gorgeous, and I'm very proud of you.
I have to go along with that, and she made me proud that. Beautiful. I'm lost for words. I can't say anymore. I love you, Lou, and Richard, take care of her. I love you both.
You, Richard.
God bless you.
This glass, Niamh.
Walk.
Walk. Shut to walk up. Whoa. Who is? He's massive.
Oh, wow.
Wow. How much is on your chin? Look, that's it.
That was really good. Oh, please.
We're going to my mommy's 70th birthday
Happy
party.
Birthday.
Where's Louise?
Where's Molly?
Oh, that's hilarious.
Oh,
Laughing is the best medicine. Look at me brother filming me ma farting in her face. Let's hear it. All the
tell
lights
him
are on.
Tell him you're not performing, monkey.
There it is.
No, that's mine for Friday.
Is it?
Yeah.
Why, what's Friday?
Friday crunchy.
Crunchy Friday.
Crunchy wasn't there?
Yeah.
Nowhere to go.
Wasn't there. And that's mine goes in there. Thank you.
I don't have to go on the back.
I did ask you, so you just wanted apple pie.
Oh, there's another one.
Hey.
Get off the phone. Who is she? Who's that is on the phone?
Nelly.
All right.
I know.
She's about to come up.
Thank you.
There's
vomit and bugs in our house.
Oh, yeah, she should be looking for vomit bugs.
Tell Kelly she's bad.
No, thanks. No, Kelly, no. No, I've got all the crap in here that it's Chinese and then...
Oh.
What do you call it? My what do I talk about?
Diabetes.
Oh, diabetic is going haywire.
Ma, just tell her you want a large packet of crisps because I'm starving.
Salted in a large packet of crisps.
She said, did she? Oh, you're a lovely she.
I stagger like as if I was drunk and I'm sober.
Niamh said hi.
Huh?
Niamh said hi.
Who's Niamh? My dog granddaughter. So many Niamhs you say. Hello Niamh.
Just look like that. Now move your eyes around that.
The other way.
Look over there.
Anyway, back to me. No, I shook your hand before that. Gary Fay, how are you? Keita's just walked in. Keita and Kira has just walked into the room. She signed her A's. Keita's holding his phone. I said, what? I'm still sitting here waiting, just my blood pressure won't go down. And I'm in dire straits. No, I don't know. Now I'm getting very worried. I'm doing nothing. I'm doing everything to tell me. Now they want me just to try to get my blood pressure down and it won't go down. Oh my God! Here.
I got cheap flies, so...
Oh
my... You got silly
hat. That? Oh Jesus Christ, son. I told you about this. Oh Jesus Christ, son. Why?
Come here, there's something I think in your garden.
Something dead.
Something dead?
Did you see?
No.
Were you out in the garden at all?
No.
No.
It's weird to God, man. There's something out here.
Oh, God. It's over here.
Jesus Christ!
Thank you.
I'll say hello.
Hiya, Gary.
Well.
Or anyone. A Merry Christmas to all. Merry Christmas to all. Didn't forget your name. Hey, yeah.
Did you know that she was coming?
No.
Oh, here we go. Let's put on the Christmas album. And we sing along with the Christmas song.
With the Christmas spirit.
The Christmas spirit. Oh. Hey, Facebook.
It's Christmas now.
You what?
It's Christmas now.
It is Christmas now. Christmas starts now, everybody. How many people we got watching?
No.
Okay, Ma. Ma, take it away.
Take it away, there, son. Robbie's singing.
Where's the music?
Okay, there's no coverage because we're in the car park. Hang on.
Hold on.
Hold your horses, everyone that's connected, all one of you.
Who's the one of them?
I don't know, Gary. I'm driving the fucking car. The fucking.
Well, you always see it doing so.
You're not allowed to curse, Keith.
Sorry, it's Christmas. There's no cursing. Please.
Why?
I nearly lost it.
Oh, Gary, what films are we going to watch tonight?
Oh, all of it.
Oh, let's stay up until like.
I want to go, it's very hard.
Just have a go shopping tomorrow.
Ma wants us to bring us shopping. Are you going at it again?
Are you going at it very hard?
And I need two of you. It's about to push me, about to shove me.
Oh.
Dirty.
I go at it awful very hard. Okay, let's get the Christmas songs going.
Go for it.
The fuck is that?
Don't know. Don't like it.
It's Alison.
Alison Mott?
Yeah.
Those reindeer. Come on, Ma, take it away.
I don't know that fucking song.
It's a fucking stupid song anyway. Bunch of bastards.
Give me the real Christmas songs.
Okay.
The better one.
It's the Christmas FM. I'm not the DJ.
Sack
him.
Yeah. Sack the DJ, sack the DJ, sack the DJ.
Sack the DJ.
Okay, we'll get a sing song going on our own.
Yeah.
I'm enjoying that.
First Noel, the angels did sing.
Was to save the poor.
No, I don't know it. The poor shepherds. We're all drunk.
They keep it their sheep.
Shit.
Sheep.
On a cold winter's night.
That was so bleak.
Noel. There we go.
Talk about being like, oh my, you
mean. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. I don't know. Little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The star in the night sky. There's the airport hopper, you could have been on it. No, you would have missed it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, because I would have had to walk over the terminal.
Oh, it's a Christmas miracle. It's a Christmas miracle. Let's see what's on the radio.
Temptations,
Gary. Come on. Come on.
Oh,
here we go. That's right. Okay, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Gary, I got rid of this 7 years ago. On a one horse open sleigh. Hey! Jingle bells, jingle bells. Gary, sing all the way. Wrap up dear old Santa Claus, gonna wrap up Christmas Day. A fucking through the snow. In a one horse open sleigh. Through the fields we go. Fucking laughing all the way. Bells and bobsleighs ring. While making some
right.
On Christmas Day tonight. Come on, motherfucker! Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Leashin' each hero with your deedle diddle oo and a hooba daddle deedle Gary Fay. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight?
Get your cheeky Charlie now!
I think you remember that.
birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Gary. Happy birthday to you.
Just birthday next week.
Here comes the bride. Here comes the bride. I don't know. Is there any more?
40 inches wide.
40 inches wide.
40 inches wide.
Oh, I have a good song we can sing.
What?
Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty together again. Gary, you're next. It's karaoke with your mouth forward. The red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose. What about A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time won't you... Matt, you're next. Pick a song. Sing it there.
Sing a 7-6 with the falcon full of rye.
4 and 20 blackbirds baked in a pie.
When the pie was opened, the birds began to sing. Oh, wasn't that a lovely way to get the king?
That was a terrible dish to set before the king. The king was being good.
I sang at the Tommy yesterday.
Sorry?
I sang at the Tommy yesterday.
Did you?
Wow. You know what that means? We're reptilians. NYPD choir, we're singing Galway Bay. And the bells are ringing out for Christmas Day.
I love you, baby.
You scumbag, you maggot, you cheap, lousy faggot. Happy Christmas.
And the Coca-Cola.
I'm sweating.
I'm starving.
I'm Joni.
She wants soup.
Yeah.
Oh. She wants it. She's been very difficult. Very difficult.
And I want to get peace.
She wants peace.
She wants
and
peace.
Soup.
She wants peace.
Right, off there. Do you want that one?
Yeah.
Or do you want this one? Do you want this one? Do you want this one? She's very, very difficult.
Now, up here,
the
like
violence,
peace.
The aggravation.
Can you shout next to me again? I wish to Jesus I could. There'd be somebody shopping at this too.
We'll leave it at here. We'll leave it
at here. It'll be on YouTube.
That's my mother playing Cards Against Humanity, having a Bailey's. Show us one of your answers, ma'am.
No, you're not letting me hear answers.
No.
Okay.
Was that yours, Lenny?
That was you. Mad mother retired to South France.
Yeah.
Okay. I get it. Okay, Ma, how are you getting on?
I'm fine. I don't know.
I was only in a man before, and I was only one.
You were only one?
Yeah.
Hi. Hello. Get there. Get that spread on my plate. That's my plate.
Sorry.
You put everything on the floor now.
I don't care. I have to stay. Sorry, off the shit.
Where's my plate?
That one.
On Friday night, a beautiful, caring and generous light went out in the world. My mother, Joni Faye, touched the hearts of so many people. I would like to remember her now and give you all a bit more insight into just how incredible a person she was. Before I go any further, I will tell you, she left explicit instructions that she wants everyone to cry at her funeral. She had a great sense of humour, right up to her last moments. When the palliative care team came in on her final day on earth, she checked my mum was comfortable, then asked if she could do anything else for her. My mom answered, "Make me better," and cracked up laughing. The nurse didn't know what to say, and that just sums up my mom. Mam was born in 1947 when everything was black and white and people walked fast. Her mam Susie and dad Jack did a great job bringing her up. She smashed her toe on the shore when she was very young. A sore toe bothered her as a kid and again right at the end of her life. She left Ireland at a young age to begin a life of adventure travelling the world. In reality, she went to the arsehole of Scotland, got a job plucking chickens, lost some jewellery in the chicken's arse and left. She then returned to Ireland within 2 weeks after her mother came to bring her home. Her travelling days were over. She met my dad in the Arcadia where he used to sing. She would go there with a friend and both of them would slag my dad off, calling him Chicken Nick. Then one day she had to tell her friend, "I'm shifting Chicken Nick." They were married in 1971 in St. Michael's Church, Dunleary. There was no expense spared on their honeymoon and they were the envy of everyone they knew when they told them where they were going. Tala. They had planned to go to Cork, but my dad's sister had just bought a house in Tala and they decided they wanted to go there instead, as you do, lol. They lived in the epitome of apartment luxury in the 1970s, Fatima mansions, eventually settling in Killinard, which she called home until the end. There she made many new lifetime friends and became a strong part of the community. Some of you probably remember her days collecting the church envelopes, or when it was raining, we collected the church envelopes. She was also involved in the summer projects. Others may remember her as the Avon Lady, a job she thoroughly loved. In later life, she sold cards for my cousin Yvonne. She also worked as a cleaner in the community school. This was always a problem for my brother John when he went on the Mitch, as the teachers would always tell her when he was missing. She was a tough woman and had no problem giving us a smack on the arse when we were bold. I remember one Christmas when John was a bold little boy. He robbed Charlie Strong's garden gnomes and hid them in her shed. He was caught red-handed and there was no Santa for John that year. Actually, John did receive one present that year from her dear Auntie Anne, my mother's beloved sister, who sadly passed away only 10 weeks ago. Mam was tough in other ways, as anyone who knows what she went through over the last 3 years will tell you. 2 years ago, she was given only 3 days to live. She lasted 2 years. We called it a Christmas miracle, but it wasn't a miracle. It was all horror. She had the most amazing attitude. She took everything on the chin. She was the very definition of a fighter. She never complained. Even when her hand became dark blue from the weeks and weeks of daily blood samples being taken. The constant poking and prodding. She just got on with it. She never complained. Over the last 3 months, it was the same. And in her last week with us, she laughed with us, she cried with us. We made funeral arrangements together. Then true to form, she laughs and says, "Is this what fucking dying is like?" I answered, "You tell us. You tell us you've done it twice." As she was a diabetic, had heart failure and kidney disease, she had a strict diet and couldn't eat a lot of things she loved. When they broke the news that she may go in a few days, she had chicken balls and curry sauce, her last meal. My family and I don't want to make you sad. We want to make you happy and delight in the fact that you knew Joni. She was crazy and she loved life. Our first family holiday was to the Isle of Man and was a typical Fae family event. Dad came home pissed the day before we were to leave. He went to bed. Mam took his money. We left him in bed and off he went and I had a great time. She did miss him but also had extra money so it was grand. She was never a political person and took most things in her stride except the IRA. She never liked the IRA. Until one day, the Republican political prisoners in Port Leash sent her a signed Get Well Soon card from all of them. She spent hours showing everyone on the war saying, "Look what the IRA said to me, aren't they lovely?" She made some great friends on her road in Killinarden and was devastated when her bestie next door neighbour Marie Corley died. But things turned full circle and she was blessed to have Marie's daughter Jennifer move into the same house. Jennifer helped my mother so much in her final years and we are eternally grateful to her. Usually people speak in their eulogies of the great encouragement and support their mother gave them. My man literally told me not to get a job because her rent will go up. No, she did support us in so many ways, but it's the little sacrifices she made that stick with you. When Louise had Dylan, Mam gave up the master bedroom and both our parents moved into the box room to give them space. She always allowed John and I rehearse in the house when we were starting at the Cruicon. Although she would occasionally burst on the door saying, "You're using all my electricity." My brother Gary, or as he prefers to be called, Glitter Queen Fanny LaRue, presented a unique scenario to my man when he came out of the closet. Mam was old-fashioned and her reaction to Gary being gay was, "Are you sure you haven't found the right woman?" The truth is, she had no problem at all. No one in the family did. My mother loved Gary with all her heart and soul. Her eyes would light up as bright as the sun when she would see me. All she ever wanted for Gary, all she ever wanted for her children, was for us to be happy. In her last moment, she told us the thing that upset her most was knowing how heartbroken we all will be when she leaves us. How heartbroken her grandchildren and great-grandson will be to lose their beloved Nanny Joanie. And how heartbroken her army of honorary grandchildren will be, who also call her Nanny Joanie. A lot of people have followed her journey over the years on Facebook, whether it be her own posts or the family sharing things we were getting up to with her. She was always a bit nosy, so Facebook was a dream come true for her to have a nose of what's going on with friends and family. She had some hilarious mishaps on there as well. So many times we would receive a notification that Joan Faye is live, and we click on it to see her feet. She was accidentally broadcasting her feet to the world. Then there's a time she would accidentally check into a black metal concert in Chicago. But most of her time spent on there was telling the world how much she loved her children, her grandchildren, her great-grandson and family, or how much she missed loved ones that had passed on. She loved bingo. Everyone knows that, but it really was the one thing that she absolutely looked forward to. If she could have played every day, she would have. She had lots of bingo buddies and loved to meet them for a game and a few Coors Lights afterwards. She partnered with her good friend Mary, and for years they have always shared their winnings. By the way, Mary is currently interviewing for a new bingo partner. So many times Mam called me for a lift to bingo on a Saturday night. Of course, I never said no, who would? But I feel guilty thinking back to some of the nights when I was tired, I would have preferred to stay on the couch. I would give anything in the world to drop her to bingo again. In her last few months, it was different. I took her to bingo and stayed with her and had the privilege of being with her for her last ever game. Before I go any further, I would like to thank all the staff in Tala Hospital who took care of her, became friends with her and loved her. But there was one very special person that I need to thank, that everyone in this church needs to thank. You can have your Superman, your Batman, but if anyone wants to see what a real superhero looks like, there's one sitting in that chair right there, my sister Louise. She did so much for my mother that I find it hard to actually put into words. Personal sacrifices she made so she could become a full-time carer for my mom was inspirational. We all love our mother, but there is something special about the love between a mother and daughter. Louise was ready to donate a kidney to my mother if it would have helped her. Her heart is broken and will probably never heal, but Louise, we thank you so much for all you've done. And so we go back to Friday night in the hospital that became a second home to my mom. In the end, she left us much quicker than anyone expected. All her grandchildren came in that day, her family, her friends. So many had a chance to say goodbye, and understandably, a lot did not because it was so bloody quick. Louise and I expected to spend that night with her, and maybe she would hold on for Gary to get home on Saturday. But as the hours counted down, we knew she was going. Marion, Karen and Tara stayed with us. John was there. Jared came back to the hospital. When she took her final few breaths, she was embraced by us all. We held her hand and told her we loved her. We thanked her for everything. We rang Gary, we got him on the phone, and we held the phone to her ear. He spoke to her. She left us surrounded by her children's voices. She had the most peaceful, beautiful, and dignified exit from her world. And I'm sure she was smiling and proud of us all when she met Susie, Jack, Christy, John, Patrick, and Anne in the next life. Mam, you'll never be forgotten. You were and are an absolute legend.
Okay, so after the count of three, we're going to... Now, every month we invite viewers to get involved in our camera club. This month the theme was A Mother's Love, given the month that's in it and all the rest of it. And of course, as part of the prize, we team up with Birmingham Cameras, and today's lucky winner will get a new Sony A5100, is it?
Yeah.
50, it's just numbers to me. Anyway, it's worth over €450. So that's a hell of a nice price. Photographer Jenny McCarthy joins us now alongside this month's three Camera Club finalists. Now, Mother's Love, you picked the theme.
Yes.
And I thought, this is going to break her heart.
Oh, God. What did I do to myself?
Well, but it's a beautiful theme. And obviously, given the month that's in it, next Sunday we've got Mother's Day. Obviously, it was the right one to pick.
Made sense.
But lots of really emotive, evocative and heartbreaking photographs.
Oh, completely. I mean,
right,
you
let's start with our first. This is Margaret Walsh. Hello, Margaret. Right, third and finally, we have Louise Tyrrell. Hello, Louise. How are
Hi.
You?
I'm not too bad.
Where are you from?
I'm from Lucan.
You're from Lucan.
Yeah.
Okay. Am I right in thinking or saying you've never had a camera?
Never.
Never.
No. A few windy up ones, you know, from years and years ago.
Throwaway job.
But you've never actually, I mean, you know, the other two ladies here were showing off their kind of their 60D and their 40D and their, their XYZ, whatever. But you've never had one.
Just the phone. I would take photographs, obviously, on my phone.
Okay, now there's a story to this picture, so
there is a story,
and it's a very personal one. You don't mind telling it?
No.
Okay,
it's bittersweet, I suppose. Mam was very ill. I looked after her for 18 months, and near the end, we were in telehospital, and basically, I was sitting there holding her hand, and I just—it's strange what goes through your head at moments like that. But I just remember, I knew this was going to be the last time that I was going to have this personal connection with her, so I wanted to capture it. So I took the photograph. And sadly, she passed away 2 hours after the photograph was taken.
Oh.
And that was 2 months ago.
Oh.
But I get a lot of comfort out of the photograph because what I see is me. I was there for her. She was there all my life and I was there for her.
And there's the connection. I'm not sure what more we can say, Jenny, really. I think, can I just go and have a cry?
I know, it's very bittersweet, I know, but
I know, it's beautiful, it's absolutely beautiful. It was heartbreaking as well, though.
Yeah, and I can't really look at her average normal pictures at the moment. It's still a bit raw, but I do. Jenny was actually on the telly when I was crying one morning looking at it, and she mentioned the word, the mother's love, and I went, that's mother's love. Well, in my heart, and yeah.
Okay, Jenny, follow that.
Well, nothing says a mother's love like this picture, really, when you think about it. And like I said loads of times before, I don't actually read the story behind the pictures until I've picked the picture, because I'm always afraid that my heart is going to lead as opposed to kind of what I should be looking at. But sometimes composition rules go out the window when it comes to a really, really good shot. And when it came to the theme this month, I just feel you really, really nailed it. And I did know when I looked at the picture that there was probably going to be a sad ending to it. But I looked at her hand and I looked at the way you were holding her hand and I just thought, God, that hand has been through so much in her life, you know, and she's a mother and she's reared her children and there's just a great story to it. And sometimes, you know, you don't have to photograph a person. You can just zoom in on a detail. And I just think you absolutely nailed it.
Listen, before we all end up in floods of tears, would you...
Sorry, God.
Take a bit of tissue. These are technically brilliant. Emotionally, though, but am I right? I never, ever know. I never, never know which one is the winner, but I think I'd be...
Yeah,
but
Louise,
right?
You're the winner
Louise,
this month.
Well done. Congratulations.
It's just amazing.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, amazing.
Oh.
Well done.
I'm sorry.
No, I know. It's beautiful.
It's a
lovely
cry.
Story. I know, it is. And I don't know what to say. Congratulations to all of you.
Well done.
You're the winner.
Thank you.
You can't enter again. But the two of you, we will see you again shortly, because these are technically
amazing.
Superb. Right. And thank you to Birmingham Camera for that Sony camera.